Hello guys, this is Art from Open Source Channel and welcome again to a new episode on How To. Don't forget you can follow me on my website, you can follow me on YouTube. And of course, don't forget you can follow me also on Twitter. Today I'm going to show you how to install a new software thanks to the we done it pretty good with the last tutorial with Mobirise. So today I'm going to show you another application. You can use Pixlr. Pixlr is a software from Autodesk. It comes as two versions, free and pro. You can use the pro version, I think, free of charge using the web app, as you can see here. You can use Pixlr and Pixlr Express. But today I'm going to show you how to install the Windows version. Also, there's two versions, for one for iOS and one is for the Google Android. So let's go to the desktop and let's download the latest version. There we go. We can buy here for $1.99 per month, $1.99 and $14.99 per year. That logically the difference between the two. I'm going to show you which one they are now. Here we go, this is the free version, and this is one is the pro version. You can pay monthly, you can pay yearly. $1.99 per dollar, sorry, $1.99 or $14.99. It's quite cheaper if you pay in one go. I'm going to skip it, and I'm going to download. Logically, if you register with your email, you can access more functions, as I will show you later on. Here we go, this is the file that I have downloaded. I'm going to double click and I'm going to extract into a folder on my main hard drive. I'm going to press run. Install. Although what it's doing, it's not installing, but it's extracting the file for the installation. Sorry for the background noise, I'm doing some work with the hard drive and I don't know why this hard drive is quite noisy, so sorry about this guys. Yeah, as I was saying before, Mobirise was very successful. The one I showed you was 1.6. Now you can actually download the 1.7. That was released about 3 days after I done the tutorial. So yes, go and check out the 1.7. It's quite good. The new blocks you can use. Here we go, now it's the Pixlr installation starting. It shouldn't take long. Choose the language you want and press install. I'm going to accept it, go next, and now I'm going to press install. Here we go, that's finished. Click finish and I'm going to double click on the icon until the program starts. I'm going to press OK. Now we're going to open an image from the ARM disk, and we're going to open a file that is inside the pictures folder. It's the one that comes as standard in Windows 7. I'm going to choose desert, and I'm going to show you a couple of filters. You can have overlay effect, borders. Over here, when you see the cloud, everything is in the cloud. You need to download it from Autodesk, as you can see here. Those ones already comes together, and it's quite fast. As soon as you click on the icon on the picture, it automatically changes the effect. As you can see, you need to create an account if you have already done it before you downloaded the actual file. But if you did, you can do it straight away. If you have not, you can do it now. You can use Facebook as well, so it's quite easy. Here you can write anything you want, position or whatever you want it. You can see here you can blur it. Color correction with hue, saturations. Brightness or lightness. And vibrance. Vibrance is quite good. I like a lot. But on this picture, it's quite vibrant itself, so you won't see much differences. But as you can see, it works perfectly well. It's quite fast, and the best of all, it's free. You can also find those effects on the top bar. You can have a double exposure, just choose another file, and as you do it with Photoshop, is, you know, it's quite easy. As you can see, you just manipulate as you want it, rotate it as you wish, as everything comes as a free rotate there. You can have the layer styles and if you click in the middle you can actually drag and drop. Here you can actually have the resize. And you can resize, as you can see, both ways. There you go. And when you press apply, it should automatically stay there. Of course, I'm not doing anything fancy. I'm just showing you a little bit around how it works. Again, you can type anything you want. We're going to type hello. And I'm going to show you another little of course you can have zoom in and zoom out, and you can also use your keyboard shortcut to do so. Let's see if I can find one of the one I like a lot. It's a kind of it's kind of a focus. You can actually here we go, this is quite perfect, something I really like, very easy to use. If you want to focus something in the photograph, as you can see, there are two rings, the inner and the outer rings, to make sure that the one in the middle, it will actually focus the objects you want, and the focus the rest of the actual pictures is automatically done by the outer ring, as you can see here. And it's quite easy to use, as I said, and quite straightforward. You don't really need a lot of experience to get started. Anyway, thanks again guys, and thank you for sharing, watching my videos. But don't forget, the more you share, the more videos I can do. Thanks again guys, and I'll see you next time for a new episode on how to.